I am Julie Brigham Grady from the University of Massachusetts Amherst, and I study past climate change, that is, the natural climate variability of the geologic past, to understand how glacial systems, the ocean, and the atmosphere responded before, in the past, to global warming, and what it can tell us about our future. Looking at ancient shorelines around the world, from Alaska to Scandinavia, South America, and Australia, we can use these shorelines like bathtub rings around our coastline to understand the record of sea level in a warmer world and how today's rate of sea level is becoming irreversible. We are already committed to 2 to 3 meters of sea level rise in the coming centuries, given only a 1 degree increase in global temperatures. This is much like the last interglacial, when sea level was even higher due to global factors that act much in a manner like greenhouse gases today. But global sea level will increase even more at temperatures above 1.5 degrees. Keeping the world below 1.5 degrees will slow down the rate of sea level rise. During the 20th century, global mean sea level has been increasing and accelerating. All studies show that the Greenland ice sheet will dominate sea level rise in the coming decades due to surface melting, especially after we lose all of the summer Arctic sea ice within the next 25 years. It's one of those feedbacks that makes preserving as much of the sea ice as possible so important. This study shows that the extent of serious surface lowering of the Greenland ice sheet in a scenario above 2 degrees. Antarctica is also a serious concern. Under a low emissions scenario, that's the black line in this diagram, sea level will continue to rise, but at a much lower rate. A good outcome is that under this lowest mission scenario, Antarctica would contribute only centimeters to global sea level rise in the coming century. But the longer we stay at higher temperatures, the higher sea level will go, and the greater will be the chance that the next generation will be locked into higher sea levels that will challenge society. During the last deglaciation, from about 14.7 to 13.5 thousand years ago, sea level rose as much as 16 to 25 meters in only 400 years. That's as rates of 40 to 60 millimeters per year. So it's not impossible. As geologists know, if it happened before, it could happen again. And there's high agreement that recent Antarctic ice sheet mass losses could be irreversible for decades to millennia. Processes controlling the timing of future ice shelf loss and the extent of ice sheet instability could increase Antarctica's contribution to sea level. The loss of the ice shelf buttressing is a key factor. Those are largely red areas in this figure. But slowing the greenhouse gas emissions down now will also slow down the loss of these ice shelves. Sea level rise will challenge adaptation responses regionally and worldwide. Here we show the largest impacts will be on flat, low-lying coastlines around, parts of the United Kingdom. Here, with a 1 degree increase in temperature, we see a 3 meter rise in sea level, 1.5 degrees at 5 meters, and even 2.3 degrees up to 10 to 20 meters above global sea level. So here you will see the different levels from around London, Liverpool, Manchester. You can see it just emphasizes how flat these areas are. And here we are finally at the COP26 in Glasgow next year. So given our knowledge of past activity, we can confidently state that by slowing down the rate of warming, we can decrease the rate of sea level rise that really put communities in harm's way and give them more time to respond. So the choices we make now determine the trajectory of sea level rise. Just imagine, and particularly in this upper left-hand green box, just imagine a sea level rise of 85 centimeters higher than today, when today's first graders are 85 years old. Will it be worse or will it be better for them? We now have to make that choice for them. Thank you very much.